Newkirk, you ever gonna finish whatever it is you're working on over here?
Good one, you ponce.
Now that your rig's upgraded, test it out on a deep core T-energy reservoir in the North Plains. Braddock out.
Still well to the osmosis plant. Still well.
Am I the only one noticing the storms are getting worse?
So I turned the corner and the assassin was standing here about to shoot Her Highness. One thing led to another and before you know it...
Let me guess, you became their king.
No, didn't be silly. I'm an archbishop.
Okay.
Welcome back, Jim.
Damn it, Kale!
Oh, sorry, dude. Did you not know I was here?
Do you not remember the conversation we had about personal boundaries?
No, I really don't.
Of course you don't.
Thank you. and he may yet survive. But how much longer will he sleep? I am certain only of this. There will be consequences for what I have done.
Gracie, I'm so sorry I worried you. I'm fine. I just found myself off the grid for a spell. Nothing I planned on. It's a long story, and you'll hear it, I promise. Just stay strong, doll. Talk soon.
This is looking like a fine place for a deep core reservoir. Okay. That's bananas. Gale, do you copy?
Jim, let me guess. You just put Gertie into platform mode, didn't you? Is that not insane?
You've outdone yourself this time, no doubt about it.
Here's how it works. Once you start the drill, you'll have a limited amount of time before thermal pressure collapses the pocket. So keep the rig functioning at all times to get every last drop of T-energy. The rig won't self-repair while platformed, so you'll have to make repairs by hand.
Wait, why will I need to make repairs?
About that. See, the deep core drilling causes intense vibration, so you'll likely attract, every acrid in the area. Probably should have mentioned that earlier. Whoops, have fun, gotta go!
We'll be right back.
I got a full tank.
Excellent work, Jim.
James, it's Roman. It's time we met on that topic we discussed earlier. In fact, it's urgent. Come see me at my pod as soon as you're able.
When I first got this job, it was a dream come true. I thought of Braddock as one of my closest friends. I believed him when he called Coronis a family. I looked past the fact that deep down, I didn't fit in there. In retrospect, I never was one of them. Even when I worked, slept, ate under their roof, I was made to feel like a stranger. I realize I'm not the easiest person to know. Never mastered the art of small talk or clever conversation. But wouldn't a true family look past that? Yet when the storms rage, each worse than the last, I think of them. I know they're a step closer to doom. And I know I can't let that happen. Family's a bitch.